Do-it-yourself alarm system using Home Assistant and several smart sensors is very easy. And today, I'm about to share my experience on how I did mine alarm in my RV. I'll talk about camper alarm here, but the principle and the process is exactly the same if you wish to create a Home Assistant alarm in a home, office or whatever. The end goal is the following. When I enter in my camper, a smart motion sensor or a door window contact sensor will detect this action and the Home Assistant alarm will go into pending state, in which I have to enter a secret predefined code within several seconds. If the code is correct, the alarm will be disarmed and nothing more will happen until the alarm is armed again. Otherwise, if the code is not correct or the pending seconds passed without any code entered, the alarm will be triggered. Depending on the preferences and the device that you have, sound, lights, phone, notifications and calls can be automatically started to inform you that there is a potential intruder.
Alarm. The alarm has been triggered.
That is the general idea on a high level. Here is what software and devices are needed this to become reality. First thing is a working Home Assistant. If you don't have such yet, you can register for my webinar where I'll talk in details about the official ways to run Home Assistant plus one stupid easy way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. Next thing that is needed is one or more smart security sensors that can be a motion sensor, door window contact sensor, vibration sensor or something similar. The only condition is this sensor to be able to work with Home Assistant. I will use Shelly Motion 2 sensor for today's video and I will leave a link to my DIY human presence sensor tutorial in the video description if you want to make a motion sensor by yourself for only $5. All other things from now on that I'm about to say are optional or nice to have. For example, a control panel. It will be good to have such device mounted near the entrance, but it is not a must. You can always use your phone to dial the alarm code. Using a control panel is just more convenient, because if you forget your phone, you will not be able to enter inside your place without activating the alarm. If you want more information about how to make your own smart home control panel, check my video from last week, where I'm explaining how I did mine. Next optional things are smart speakers, smart sirens and smart lights. These are needed if you want to start playing some alarm sounds, text-to-speech messages or light effects when the alarm is triggered. If you don't want such additional special effects, you can always send some notifications to your phone silently without informing the intruder in any way. I will leave some links in the video description to such compatible speakers, sirens and lights if you want to check them out. Next and final option thing before I move on to the implementation are more security sensors. This entirely depends on your preference and the level of security that you want to achieve and of course of the premises that needs to be guarded. It is totally different if you want to guard an entire house with several floors compared to a single room or, as it is in my case, a motorhome. It is your choice whether to add just one motion sensor, for example, or dozen. As well, whether to add contact and vibration sensor on every window and door that you have. Now, here comes the good part. The actual implementation. Inside Home Assistant, I will open the file editor add-on, which is available as one-click install in the Home Assistant add-on store. Using the file editor, I'll open my Configuration.yaml file. Inside it, I'll paste the following code. This is actually adding the manual alarm control panel platform, which will allow me to create the alarm system in Home Assistant and to add the alarm card on the dashboard, as you see later. Every row here is well described, but here is a quick summary what actually this code is doing. Alarm control panel with platform manual. The name will be home alarm, but it can be anything. The code is 1234. This code will be used to disarm the alarm, and again, it can be anything. When this is false, you can arm the alarm without entering the code. This will not allow the alarm to be disarmed after it has been triggered. the time in seconds in which you have to leave your home after arming. This option specifies how many seconds you have when you enter in your home to disarm the alarm. This specifies how many seconds the alarm will be active. And the last one will prevent the alarm to be triggered when it is in disarmed mode. Don't try to remember this YAML code. Just get it from the video description or from the Home Assistant documentation. I'm also using the Home Assistant documentation and I just added few slight modifications. I will save the changes and I will restart my Home Assistant. And when Home Assistant has started, I will add the alarm card on my dashboard so I can arm and disarm the alarm from the provided card that have a keypad for the code and arm and disarm buttons. And with that, I'm almost ready. I just have to add few Home Assistant automations. Let me explain. The first automation will be triggered from the security sensors, in my case, the one and only Shelly Motion 2 sensor. There will be one condition checking if the alarm current state is armed away. If that is the case, the automation will execute the action, which is to put the alarm system in pending mode. That means the Home Assistant alarm will expect the correct code to be entered so that it can be disarmed. The automation will also send a notification to my phone and a persistent notification to remind me that the alarm is expecting to be disarmed. The second automation will send notifications to my phone and will call me when the alarm is actually activated. In other words, if the entered code is wrong or no code is entered at all within the predefined pending time, the third and final automation will be activated when the alarm is successfully disarmed, because the correct security code was entered, and the automation will just send notification to my phone that the alarm is disarmed. The YAML code of these automations can be found in the video description. You can copy and paste the automation's code in your Home Assistant and you can freely modify them to your preferences. But there is more! I have to test everything. So I will pretend that I'm a burglar. I'll enter in my camper and I'll start looking for valuable items. Immediately, I'll receive a message saying that motion is detected and security code has to be entered. After 20 seconds, as I predefined using the delay time option in my Home Assistant alarm settings, I will receive another message and a call saying that alarm is activated exactly as expected. So I can freely go and kick out the intruder. Thankfully, the intruder is me, but I can't kick myself out, don't I? Anyways, in the next case, I will enter the camper again, but this time I will enter the correct security code and everything will be fine. And no violence will be needed, and I'll receive a message on my phone saying that the alarm is disarmed. And just like that, I have a working, smart, Home Assistant-based alarm system in my camper using one motion sensor and 10 minutes of my time. Download my smart home glossary from my website for free and use it whenever you face an unknown smart home word or acronym. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill. See you next week. Bye.